Joining us now is the former Attorney General of India as well as top legal voice, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi. Thank you so much for speaking to NDTV. Mr. Rohatgi, first of all, your opinion on what you think about this Madhya Pradesh political crisis. I mean, you must have seen many over the past few years, but what do you think about this one? From a legal standpoint, sir.
See, it's clear to me that the Speaker has violated the Constitution. For several reasons. The first, the governor is the highest constitutional authority who is to uphold democracy in the state. When the governor is aware of the reasons why the government doesn't have majority, he asks the speaker to hold a flow test. And mind you, the flow test is the only way in which it can be found whether a party commands the majority of the house or does not command. That's the only real place, not the governor's house, not the speaker's house, not the chief minister's house. Floor of the house is the place where you have to decide. Now, it is clear to me, and I have been watching TV as all your other viewers have been watching, that 22 MLAs, out of which 6 are current ministers, have tendered their resignation. They are currently in Bangalore. They are afraid to come to Bhopal because of the government and the police being under the government. They are fearful of their life and security. In fact, Mr. Sindhia also suffered an attack on his vehicle. So if they have freely and voluntarily, while coming on TV on several occasions, said that they have voluntarily resigned, and curiously, 6 out of those 22 resignations have been accepted by the Speaker. I don't know what is the difference between those 6 and the remaining 16. It is clear to me that Congress does not command majority in the House. The Speaker should have honored the directive of the Governor, and a floor test should have been held today. In any case, even if the budget had been presented, it's a finance bill, the government would have fallen even without a trust vote. So I don't know if there is any other escape route for the government, because 22 out of 114 which the Congress has got has gone away. So obviously they are down to somewhere like 94 or 95. While you require 114 out of a strength of 228, started with 230, now it's 228. The fact that the Speaker has not followed the directive is one constitutional defiance. The second and more abominable is to adjourn the assembly for 10 days so that the assembly doesn't meet at all. I don't think the Speaker could have shut up the assembly or shut off the assembly by saying that till 26th it is not there.
Now, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, one of the reasons why this has been done, Mr. Rohatgi, and you know, this will require some legal understanding. One of the reasons why this has been done is due to coronavirus. Now, I feel that in all the previous cases, this is perhaps the one unique thing this time around. Now, how do you hold it against a government, or say, for instance, hold it against a speaker when he says that, look, we've been preaching to the world that large congregations should not be allowed or should be banned? Then I'm implementing the same rule in my assembly.
Look, coronavirus cannot result in suspension of democracy. And if 100 or 150 people or 200 people have to meet, they can jolly well wash their hands with sanitizers, as I have done in the Supreme Court today. They can be checked with a thermal thermometer, and they can be asked to come in. And such a vote of confidence can take only 5 minutes. It's not that it's going to take 5 hours. It's a vote by division. You press a button and you decide whether you are for the government or you are against the government. And out you go. The whole thing can be done, you know, in 10 minutes. So this is a very, very weak and a palpably transparent and a false defense, if you ask me.
Now, let's, Mr. Rohatgi, talk about the legal arguments being mounted. So, I'm sure you're aware of of a letter war between the governor as well as the chief minister, Kamal Nath. So the governor writes a letter saying that you hold the floor test because I believe that you do not have the majority. To which Mr. Kamal Nath has written a 6-page letter back to the governor where he says, and you know, this involves legality, that's why I would want your opinion. He says that in the Supreme Court, in a matter related to Nabam Rabia and Bamam Felix versus Deputy Speaker Arunachal Pradesh. Yes. And then he quotes paragraph 173 where he says, in our considered view, the governor's connectivity to the house in the matter of sending messages must be deemed to be limited to the extent considered appropriate by the Council of Ministers headed by the Chief Minister. There are at least 4 or 5 different paragraphs that conclude that the governor overstepped his brief by asking the house to conduct a floor test. How do you respond?
Well, the example is completely inappropriate and inapt. The position of the assembly in that case was entirely different. Here the facts are transparent, they are admitted. If 22 have gone away, do you mean to say that the Supreme Court said that if the government has got lost majority, it is the will of the Chief Minister to carry on when the Constitution says that only a democratically majority government will rule? How is it possible? That was a completely different situation. That situation does not apply here. And mind you, I have been on the other side in the last 2 or 3 cases, starting from Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Karnataka 1, which happened in 2018, if I am not mistaken.
Correct.
Where the Supreme Court in a midnight hearing said that the speaker cannot dilly-dally, even if the speaker was with one partisan with one party or the other, and a floor test must be held within the same day or 24 hours. That's what happened in Maharashtra and Karnataka 1. Hmm. Where is the question of now somebody saying, I'll hang on? Mr. Kamal Nath is saying, in other words, I will hang on, notwithstanding the Constitution, notwithstanding that we live by democracy. Can that ever be allowed?
No, but Mr. Rohatgi, will you or will you not agree that the responsibility of conducting a floor test lies solely with the Speaker and not with the Governor? Because the Governor again has written back the letter and saying pretty much what you are saying. And he has again urged Kamal Nath government to hold a floor test tomorrow, despite the fact there is a 10-day recess. Mr. Rohatgi, can you hear me?
Correction chala gaya bhai.
Okay, we seem to have lost that connection with Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, who is the former Attorney General, saying that Mr. Kamal Nath is attempting to hold on to power, hold on to the position of the Chief Minister, whereas clearly the numbers don't add up and a floor test immediately is the need of the hour. We'll stop for a short break. Be right back.